In this video tutorial, we will see how to create a gateway service modeled from a dictionary view. This uses the Saddle Gateway integration capabilities available as of SAP NetWeaver 7.4 SP5. The scenario and application model used in the video is a standard EPM model. For more details, please refer to the SCN links shown here. The process of modeling a gateway service from a data dictionary view consists of the following steps. Firstly, as a prerequisite, certain gateway-specific configuration has to be performed. Please refer to the documentation link that you see on the screen for more details. On the application side, all the calculation logic and output is defined in the HANA layer in the form of calculation view. In order to consume the HANA view in the ABAP layer, a data dictionary view is to be created. And finally, to expose the dictionary view as an OData service, the gateway service has to be modeled from the dictionary view. This will be the focus of this particular video. For this demo, I will use an existing HANA calculation view that calculates the average number of days the invoices of our customers are open. It also calculates the sum of amount of these open invoices, including currency conversion, and it sets a flag by customization values to identify critical customers to whom the reminders have to be sent. As you can see from the output in the data preview, the business partner ID, the company name, currency code, customer tagging flag, average days open, and the sum of gross amount have been displayed. In order to consume the HANA calculation view in ABAP, a dictionary view has been created. So you can see the fields of the view, the map dedict types, which correspond to the HANA types of the underlying HANA calculation view. We will now look at how the dictionary view can be exposed as an OData service using Saddle Gateway integration. First, the Gateway Service Builder has to be launched using the transaction SCGW. Then, a new project has to be created. Enter the project name and provide a description. Leave the project type as service with SAP annotations and the generation strategy as standard. Create a local object. So the project is now created. The next step is to import the data model from the previously created dedict structure. In order to do this, right-click on the data model, select Import Dedict Structure. Provide the name of the previously created dedict view and press Enter. As you see, the entity and its properties have been derived from the dictionary view. I will provide a meaningful name. And say continue. You can see that the entity type and its properties have been successfully imported. The entity set has to be created next. Right-click on the entity set and select create. Provide the entity set name as results. Specify the entity type name which was previously created. The next step is mapping the parameters of the dictionary structure and the saddle entity. To do this, navigate to Service Implementation Results node, right-click on the Results node, and select Map to Data Source. Select the type as business entity and provide the name of the dictionary view. Press continue. You will see the message that the mapping to data source was created successfully and the mapping editor is now displayed. The properties in the entity set have to be mapped to the corresponding fields in the external view. I will now trigger the generation of the runtime objects for the service. You can see that the runtime objects for this particular service were generated successfully. The next step is to register the service to the ICF. Double-click on the service maintenance node and click register. Specify the system alias where the service should be deployed. Since the service should run on our system, we enter local. Select local object and continue. So the service is now registered and activated in the ICF and it is now ready to test. Launch the SICF transaction. In the field service name, enter OPU. Navigate to the newly created service. Go to the default host SAP OPU OData SAP node, and under that you can find the newly created service. You can now test this service. The metadata XML of the OData appears in the browser. To see the results entity set, copy the results text and paste it into the browser URL and press enter. You will see the data filled in all the properties that were defined in the entity set. So you basically saw how easy it is to create gateway services from dictionary views without any programming effort on the developer's side.